Hello. I'm going to show you a demonstration of how I painted my dog a black Labrador using pastels. The stuff that I used for this painting were a textured paper that I picked up from a local stationery shop, soft pastels, pastel pencils, some regular color pencils that I've used here and there, charcoal, and a regular HB pencil for the initial sketch. This is how I set up my easel next to my computer table so I could look at the reference picture. The most important thing to make your painting look like the actual picture is to get the initial sketch exactly right. This initial sketch took me about 2 hours because I had to keep erasing and drawing again to get the proper proportions right. It actually just depends on your practice. But it's important to get it right, otherwise your painting might not resemble the picture in the end. As you can see, I've demarcated the areas which I want to shade in my sketch. I colored in the background with soft pastels. I used 2 shades of blue and a shade of purple to do this. It looks incomplete because I'll complete the background in the end. I've colored in the eye completely by now, and I've laid down the basic colors for the face. I like to work portion by portion and complete one part before moving on to the other. I see some blue and yellow in the reference picture, so I've put that in. There's a lot of brown in the picture, but if I use that much brown, the dog won't look black in the end, so I have substituted brown from a lot of places to either black or blue. After laying down the basic colors for the face, I have gently smudged them using a latex glove. This gives an even look. Some people use fancy instruments like color shapers, but I prefer to smudge with my fingers. Be careful not to smudge all the areas using one finger, or in the end the whole face would have the same shade. This is how I've colored in the eye. Now I've put in my black and shades of white and completed the face. You have to put layer over layer to get your desired result. Don't worry, if you put in too much of one color, you can always counter control it with another one. Don't forget to gently blend in all the colors before you put in the finer details, otherwise your painting won't have a smooth feel. I've also put in the basic color layout in the ear. This is how I've done the nose. A lot of white on top and a shade of blue blended into each other give a natural look. Now I've put in the black in the ear and shaded it with white and blue as I see it in my reference picture. Now the basic color layout for the neck. This portion, if you notice in the picture, has a lot of shades of brown in it. So I put down the browns as a base and worked my black on top of it. I've completed the neck now, evening out the colors softly before I pick up my white pastel pencils to give the texture of fur. And there you have it, the final painting. I've colored in the collar, I've colored in the body, and I've evened out the background. And I've put in some more finer details like the dog's whiskers if you look closely. If you're looking to draw something good, remember, you have to be patient, don't hurry and spoil a good painting, and you have to practice. You'll notice that every time you draw, it'll be better than the last time. I hope you enjoyed this demonstration. Thank you, and take care.